Well, just about to have a bit of fun to actually show you peeps. Let's take my glasses off. Hello? No, this is not it's not William Egg, this is Alex here, he's Under Secretary. Who's on the line? Jacques Bloody Cousteau? Oh, Sarkozy. Hello, bonjour, Monsieur Sarkozy, bonjour. Do I speak French? Well, not a lot of French. Hold on a minute. Je ne parle plus français aujourd'hui avec moi. No, Monstru Del Boy Trot. Monstru. How can I say this? Voulez-vous avec la couchette avec moi? No? What about. Oh, you're calling up about that? Right, yeah, yeah. No, well, we haven't got an aircraft carrier. We actually sold it. Yeah. It's on eBay at the moment. I think it's £1.35 billion it's on for sale for. You'd like to lend us your aircraft carrier? Oh, well, that's très formidable. We'll have to come to some kind of arrangement, though, you know. I mean, can we borrow it, say, next month to do a couple of sea trials? Oh, that's fab. Yeah, that's great. What about, how are we going to work this with the crew and the staff? Is it going to be your crew or our crew? Because, you know, we don't want any confrontation and problems with the language and stuff like that. Oh, it'll be your crew. All right. Well, that'll serve as a lot of work, I suppose. French cuisine? No, mate. Sorry about that. Can't do a deal over that. You know, I'm not letting my boys go out there and friggin' eat frog legs while they're trying to fight a friggin' battle with Libya and stuff like that. Sorry, mate. You'll have to call somebody else. All right, goodbye. Bloody cheek. Wants us to eat pig and frog legs while we're fighting the enemy. Hello? Yeah? Yeah? No, but this is the undersecretary. I'm not actually William Egg. Who's calling? Silvio Berlusconi. Friggin' hell, who cares who wins, eh? What's going on, buddy? You want us to put a plea into the United Nations to make sure you get leading the coalition over what's happening in Libya? Why do you want us to do that? You'll allow our diplomats and our MPs free call girls if they come to Italy. Is that it? You dirty bastard. He's got a friggin' neck, hasn't he? Hello? No, you spoke to me earlier on this morning. It's Alex here, it's not William Egg. You'll offer us two aircraft carriers and one submarine, but you'll only charge us for one. Why's that then? Because you want to get involved in Libya more than anybody else. What for? Humanitarian aids? No, we're sorting all that out, mate. We're bombing the shit out of them by night and day. No, we don't need any help. You just carry on providing the planes you're providing, and we'll take off from Italy as normal, and Cyprus and Corsica and places like that. Yeah, I mean, if we need a help of you, we'll give you a ring. All right, don't worry about it. I mean, what we spoke about earlier on, you know, that's done. There's no way my lads are going to eat frog's legs out there while they're fighting the enemy. All right, catch you later. Bye. Freaking guy won't give up, man. Hello? No, this is not he, this is his secretary speaking, Alex here. Musakusa? What's that? Oh, that's your name. Sorry, Musakusa. Sounds a bit French, doesn't it? What can I do for you anyway? You want to spill the beans on what's happening in Gaddafi and what's happening in Libya? Well, that's very interesting. Yeah, we'd really like to know. I mean, you could tell us a lot of things there, couldn't you? What exactly are you expecting in return? No, can't go for that. Sorry. Right. We know you Arab people are like that. No, you'll not get any free girls here and booze while you're here. Sorry about that. Palace in Westminster? Opposite Prince Philip? No, that's out of the question as well. Sorry, you'll have to rethink that completely. I think you're asking too much here. You might get a bed sitting Stepney. Well, of course you'll be bloody police guarded all the time. We don't want you doing a frigging runner. You don't think you're going to come over here and spill the beans and then just go frigging Tesco shopping on a Friday night as if anything happened? Oh, I don't care what you do, you know. I take it or leave it. This is the options, you know. You come to England, you go on trial, right, and you'll get found guilty whether you like it or not, and you'll serve the rest of your time in prison. You're not happy about that? Well, I don't think the family and the relatives are happy about that. For the people who got killed on the Lockerbie plane, all the 239 passengers. Yeah, bollocks, go and chat with Greece. God almighty, what a cheek! Hello? No, this is Hollywood here, Duty Chipmunk speaking. Angela Merkel? Ah, guten Tag, Angela, wie geht's? Yes, I do speak a little bit of German. Yes, yes, what's the problem, Flower? Are you calling up about the problems in Libya? Well, I thought this had already been arranged. I know you and China and Russia abstained, and Turkey's been playing up a little bit, God knows why, with their human rights history. No, people don't really care. You know, you've got a good economy, you do frigging great sausages, and you do great breakfasts and stuff like that, but you can't go to war, we know that. No, if you just do what you've been doing, you know, let us use your air bases and that in Germany, right, to fly our bombers out and stuff like that. I mean, that's ample. We know you can't go to arms. It's been written in the Constitution that you can only defend yourself. You can't actually go to war. Yeah, well, I appreciate you letting us use the air bases and that and stuff like that. That's about enough, really, at the moment. Yeah, well, I'll convey the message on to him and let him know that you're a bit concerned about what's happening. You don't have any aircraft carriers, do you? Not since 1945. That's a bugger, isn't it? Never mind. All right, then. Well, thanks for the phone call, Angela. And toy, 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 as they say, in the next election. All right, Flower. Catch you soon. Bye. Hello? No, this is Alex at the Foreign Office. Mr. Egg's not here at the moment. Who's calling? President Medvedev from Russia. Oh, hello there. Hey, my dad was Russian. Do you know his family? Bielokon. Da, what Kiev? Ah, but it was formerly with Russia. I know it's not now, it's on its own country, but they've all annexed, haven't they? You know, Chechnya, Georgia and all them. I know they're not yours anymore and you're feeling a bit lonely there all on your own. What can I do for you anyway? You're not happy about the situation in Libya and what's going on? Well, I mean, we are doing our best with the coalition forces that we've got. Would have been nice if you'd have backed us instead of backing the frigging other guys, you know. Well, you did back friggin' Egypt before, didn't you? No, no, don't use that tone of voice. Come on, come on. This has got nothing to do with strategic weapons placed in other satellite countries. This is, you know, something that's going on that involves the whole of NATO and the whole of the European countries. What do you mean you'll turn the gas off and the oil? What's a bit frigging rotten in it? No. We're not going to back down, sorry. As it is, this is the way it is. We're going to bomb the shit out of Libya. And if it means going in with ground troops, then we're going in with ground troops as well. And the same goes for Afghanistan. We'll finish the job off that you couldn't do. You know, everybody know you told porkies in the 60s and 70s. That you can't even feed your own men. Some of them never got paid for a year and a half in Afghanistan. What do you mean? We pay our soldiers every friggin' month, mate. Yours never got paid for a year and a half. Well, I'm sorry the way people feel about that. You shouldn't have abstained at the UN voting. You know. Alright then. You try and sum up support elsewhere. Do svidaniya. Ciao. Freaking necky, friggin' Russian. Hello? No, he's not in the office today. It's his undersecretary here, Alex, speaking. Can I help you? Mr. Wing? Oh, hello. No, he's going to be away for the rest of the week, unfortunately, you know, with everything that's going on in Libya and everything. That's what you wanted to talk to him about. Well, I can give you his mobile if you like. I don't know where he is, what country he's in. Well, he should be able to. If he's paid his bill, yeah, he should be able to roam. Well, I'm hoping so. It's about trade with China. Why, what's up at the moment? I can't see what that's got to do with it, to be quite honest, Mr. Wing. Yeah, we know a lot of countries owe you a lot of money. Yes, and we know that if your economy is important to the world economy, even America's and Europe's. Yeah, but we can only pay it off so much at a time. We can't keep, you know. You'll cut the container ships off for Christmas. That's a bit harsh, isn't it? Do you know what that'll do if you stop the container ships coming to Europe and America? You're not interested. Yeah, well, our kids believe in Father Christmas. Well, what are they going to do Christmas Day when there's no boxes under the tree, no toys, no presents? I will. I'll pass the message on to him as soon as he comes in. I'll tell him to ring you straight away. I think that's bloody unfair. Well, you had the same chance as Russia to vote at the UN. All right then, thanks very much, goodbye, bye. Hello? Yes, this is the Foreign Office speaking, yes? No, he's away at the moment, he's going to be away till the end of the week. Who's calling? Raganga Koki from Africa. Ah, Jambo Bwana, what can I do for you? Well, you can't, no, unfortunately, no, this is the Libya hotline here, office. No, if you want to complain about things that are happening in Africa, you've got to go through another telephone number. I can give you the number if you want. Or if you follow the menu on the dialing system, it'll take you to, right, what you want, dial the number again, right, press 000, that'll take you back to option 1. When you get to option 1, then it's option 3, then it's section 4, and then you'll get through to the African office, because I don't deal with that. No, I'm only dealing with Libya at the moment. Alright men, thanks very much, bye. My mama always used to say, life is like a box of chocolates. You never know what you're gonna get when you open the box. Bye-bye, peeps.